You haven't I been? Today I'm a blackjack dealer. Tomorrow, who knows?
You said you wanted to talk about my brother. Dead for 9 years.
Yes. Nasty gunshot wound to the gut. He certainly was incorrigible, wasn't he?
Hit me. How did you know that?
I know a lot of things. But this isn't about the shot that killed him. This is about the other shot. The one that killed him.
Before?
10 years ago, liquor store clerk caught your brother in the belly with his .22. You held him in your lap as he bled all over you. You said you'd sell your soul if he'd only live. Well, he did. And now I've come for what's mine.
Look, lady, I didn't come down here with old devil role-playing. Tell me how you know about my brother, on what?
I don't think you understand the severity.
Thank you.
neurons. Your soul.
Shit.
Oh, come on. It's over. Don't you put up a pretty good fight? You should be proud of yourself.
It's not fair. He only lived a year and died in the exact same goddamn way.
Oh, I hate for you to think I was a poor sport. Tell you what, I've got a better idea. You seem to be a fellow of great skills. What if you were to put some of them to use for me?
What are you saying?
There are some troublesome souls, much like yourself, who have been evading me for too long. With skills like yours, you could get them instead of me having to waste minions on it.
What's in it for me?
You recover enough of these evil people, and I assure you, they are evil. And you can have your soul back.
So what do you say?
Do we have a deal?
Should I sign anything, or just say it, like last time? Like, deal.
Ever heard of Dr. Paul Severn? Guy behind these public health initiatives, clean needles, condoms, and all that bullshit.
The guy who's all over the TV, endorsing your pal Reverend Goodman for mayor?
I got Goodman that endorsement, actually. A few weeks back, Severn and I met up at an auction and found ourselves in a bidding war over a state-of-the-art seaplane. And being the gentleman I am, I let him win.
So he got drunk off the thrill of the win, and you got to ask for his endorsement at just the right time.
On the money. Problem is, I really wanted that plane. So you're gonna get it for me.
You want me to steal a plane? That's not exactly something I can just slip into my coat pocket.
Slip it up your ass for all I care. Just go to the marina and do the job. Now!
You saw it.
Thank you.
mean, what respectable man in Nevada doesn't need a seaplane? Damn it. Sorry, guys. Nothing stands between a man and his plane. Now for the fun part.
You think your friend is gonna be pissed?
He's had his chance to enjoy it. You know, I thought you'd put up a little more resistance when I tapped you. Part of me thinks you actually like a little blood on your hands.
You don't know anything about me, Frank.
Don't waste your time with the innocent Boston altar boy act. I didn't pick you up out of nowhere without looking into you first. You know, there's no such thing as a clean slate. Right. See you around, Jason.
Yeah?
Hey, fly guy.
Hey, Ronnie.
Nice job with the plane.
How do you know about that?
I told you, I know people. Listen, you ever want to show off your piloting skills? Go see my friend the Aviatrix. True story? I have no idea what her real name is. Like, I actually address her like that. Anyway, go see her sometime.
I might do that.
Later, Tater.